Ladies and gentlemen, we begin our episode today with, of course, again, it's going to be William Salib and Guendouzi, who started their game against Bordeaux. Marseille versus Bordeaux. They had a game yesterday. Just pointing it out because apparently that's what I'm doing. Pushing everyone into the hole against Arteta, I think. That's what I'm doing. And let's move on from this one. Yeah, the first news that I already mentioned it. So the second one is about N'Golo Kanté. So it looks like Thomas Tuchel is optimistic that N'Golo Kanté and Romelu Lukaku, they might be available for the Arsenal game just when things were not, of course, the things were going haywire for Arsenal. Well, they're now closer to hell because Kanté and Lukaku are getting ready for the game against Arsenal. So this is what Thomas Tuchel said. He says, I think N'Golo will be back in the middle of the week to get ready for Arsenal. On Tuesday, Lukaku will join in team training because Monday is a day off for everyone else. We will prepare him to be ready for Arsenal. Hopefully, he can be on the pitch. You know what? I might love to see Lukaku around, but not against Arsenal, though. Moving on, so talking more about different stuffs. Well, here's another big stuff that might be added upon is about the European Super League. It looks like the Super League is not off. The Super League will be launched in either 2022 or 2023. All 12 clubs are still on board and are only waiting for the European Court of Justice's approval, which they expect to receive in the next few months. It will not be a closed league. Now, if you ask me, IG, where did you get this news? It is from Vos Populi. Yeah, we are in 2021 and we've got some really crazy football related accounts on Twitter that are really funny to hear. But yes, that is one of the news that we are getting recently. So crazy bit of feeling that goes on with it. So Aaron Ramsdale has handed in a transfer request. Now this is according to Conrad Harrison. And Conrad Harrison says that yes, it looks like Sheffield United goalkeeper is afraid that his club is dumb enough to not let him go to a club like Arsenal. So it looks like he would take the matter in his own hands and he would want to join Arsenal instead by handing in a transfer request. If you ask me, I don't 100% believe this news at all. It would be dumb for Aaron Ramsdale to do that. I mean, of course, if the deal doesn't get done, the club that he's actually playing with will have a lot of trust issues with him. Okay, does not make any sense, but okay. Well, here's a bigger update and here's another heartbreak for all the Arsenal fans, because just when everything was already crumbling down around them, here's another brick that fell around. So Hector Bellerin wants Arsenal exit. No, that's not a bad news. He's extremely frustrated with Arsenal. The 26-year-old has told Arteta plus Edu he would take a pay cut to leave. Things are not working for him or club. Inter talks have failed. Emerson and Trippier swap ideas, but nothing close at all. Unbelievable. And Kieran Tierney created more chances in the first round of the Premier League than any other player, but to no avail. I mean, if you're just going to cross and nobody's going to be at the end of it, I swear to God, not even God would help this guy. I mean, not even Sri Ram can help him. Just they can't. There's no possibility of that. Also, Mikel Arteta has Gabriel Martinelli problem as a Brazilian is set for a new role against Chelsea. Now, it's a big problematic. We all know the pair of the strikers, Arsenal, are because of illness they were facing against Brentford. And Follen Balogun and Gabriel Martinelli were shifted, and then Nicolas Pepe became the striker. Balogun unfortunately struggled to get into the game, touching the ball just 13 times before coming off around the hour mark. That was difficult, but it looks like that Martinelli looked confused by what exactly he was supposed to be doing in the role and struggled to form any real chemistry with Kieran Tierney behind him. And that was the bigger problem. Now, Mikel Arteta, if as what Chris Wheatley says, since Aubameyang and Lacazette both are doubtful against Chelsea, probably Chris Wheatley must know more than something that we don't know at all. Or probably not, but here's a big deal. I believe they both won't be starting. If Aubameyang and Lacazette both don't start, Mikel Arteta needs to understand that either Gabriel Martinelli or Follen Balogun will be given the crazy bit of a deal of playing as a striker. I don't know if they're going to excel in it or not, but Martinelli has. He scored a wonder goal at Stamford Bridge. Can he do it again? I don't know. I really don't know, but let's see. Let's see. Let's see how things will turn out to be. It's not that these both cannot find a, you know, cannot create a striker partnership, but let's see. Moving on, so Tutto Sport have gone off on an Arsenal tangent in their Sunday edition with a very unbelievable suggestion of a double deal. Manager plus striker. Now, according to the Italian newspaper, Mikel Arteta's situation is far from being secure, and they believe that Antonio Conte might be lured in by Arsenal. And the idea would be that if Arsenal appoint Conte, then he would ask for Lautaro, and the Argentine striker falls at his former manager's feet. That is the exact words that they posted on their in their how should I say this in their report. So let's see, but it would be crazy. It would just take a very crazy amount of money to get Lautaro out of Inter. But if that's the case, then I'm pretty much sure that Simone Inzaghi is getting a very, very new squad. Like, it would be his own squad already. So I don't know how things will change. Will he bring in Ciro Immobile? Of course, they're signing in Edin Dzeko, but let's see. Duvan Zapata is linked as well, so yeah. Well, also, already mentioned, here is a reason what, according to David Ornstein, here's why Bellerin also wants to do, what he wants to do in the future is that he wants to get a place with Spain in the World Cup. And that's the idea, and because of that idea, Hector Bellerin wants to leave. Not bad, my friend. Well, Ian Wright sends Edu transfer message following Arsenal's defeat in the Premier League opener. Well, Arsenal legend Ian Wright has urged the club to make more signings. I feel it. Well, Ian Wright has things to say which probably everyone has heard about it. So he says they are going to need to do something in the transfer market, because if you're going to play against a promoted team and you're not going to at least match them for the endeavor and intensity that they're going to have, then it's going to be a long season for Arsenal. It is worrying. It's already worried a lot of Arsenal fans. I mean, it shook me. It shook everyone as to how horrible we were. We weren't even horrible like to this extent, after January. But you know, when the player depart, something wrong happens. And as of now, as things stand, I think everything is wrong at the moment. Well, moving on, as things stand in one of the major aspects, Arsenal fans have reacted to the whole Granit Xhaka situation, that Roma had 34 million to spend on Tammy but could not spend more on Granit Xhaka. So some fans have reacted to it. Says, wait, I thought Roma were broke. They could not afford Xhaka but can spend 40 million on Tammy. Another one said, so Roma are paying 34 million for Tammy but could not pay 20 for Xhaka. Am I missing something? Now Roma have got money. Poor Xhaka, another one said. Another one said, so Roma could agree a fee with Chelsea of 34 million for Tammy but vehemently declined to improve on their bid of 12 million by at least 5 for Xhaka. It shows that they didn't rate him enough to improve on their initial bid. Another one said, Roma can buy Abraham for 40 but cannot afford Xhaka. Mourinho trolls Arsenal. Another one said, Roma actually tried to bump us on the Xhaka deal, you know. LOL, 17 million euros for the Swiss captain with years of experience in top leagues, but will pay 40 for Tammy. But they were pissed. There's no doubt about it, they were pissed. Here's a clear article that suggests about the whole Hector Bellerin situation. Now, Bellerin is determined to leave Arsenal this summer. Bellerin is said to have made it clear his desire to Arteta and Edu. And it is even prepared to take a pay cut. I already mentioned this. And Arsenal were speaking to Inter Milan about a potential deal, but they failed to reach an agreement. And while there has been an interest from elsewhere, nobody has offered what Arsenal are seeking at the moment. And that's where the things have been. You know, even Jordan Henderson was linked with Arsenal. It looks like he's agreeing a new Liverpool contract. So there goes another fake news out in the window. Well, with this, I'd like to end this episode. Thank you so much for tuning in. If you seek daily Arsenal content, best place to be, consider subscribing. I will see you in the next one. Until then, cheers.